What if ghosts weren't supernatural, but scientific? Let's explore the hypothetical physics of what happens after we die. The first theory starts not with death, but with consciousness. A speculative idea called the Orch-OR theory suggests consciousness isn't just brain chemistry. It's quantum information held within our neurons. While you're alive, your brain acts like a quantum computer, organizing this information. But upon death, that fundamental data isn't destroyed. It's simply released. A ghost, then, could be a coherent structure of this quantum information, persisting after the body is gone. This would explain intelligent hauntings, a conscious entity that can interact with its surroundings. But what about ghosts that just repeat the same action over and over? This is where the stone tape theory comes in. It proposes that intense emotional or traumatic events can energetically imprint themselves onto a location, like a recording. A residual haunting isn't a spirit at all. It's a playback of that recording, triggered by specific environmental conditions. And for things like moving objects or full apparitions, theoretical physics offers an even stranger idea: multiple dimensions. M theory suggests our universe might exist alongside others. A haunting could be a temporary bleed through, an image or influence from another reality leaking into ours. So, from quantum echoes to dimensional bleed throughs, the ideas are purely speculative. There is no proof. But they suggest that if ghosts do exist, they might not be breaking the laws of physics. They might be operating on laws we just haven't discovered yet.